Hello children, today we begin with lesson number 4, construction of triangles. Now here, before we start with the first exercise, what you need to understand is what is perpendicular bisector theorem and its converse. Now what the two statements are, first one, every point on the perpendicular bisector of a segment is equidistant from its endpoints. That means, suppose if AB is a line segment and you have drawn a perpendicular bisector QT to it, it has divided QT, it has divided AB exactly into two equal parts, that's AT and TB. Okay. Now, every point which lies on this perpendicular bisector, for example, Q is a point lying on it, it is equidistant to the two endpoints. That means QA is congruent to QB. Converse, every point which is equidistant from the endpoints of a segment is on the perpendicular bisector of the segment. So if you are given QA is congruent to QB, it means Q lies on the perpendicular bisector. So these are the two parts to this theorem. First thing, if a point is lying on the perpendicular bisector, it means it is equidistant to the two endpoints of the segment. Second point, if you have a point which is equidistant to the two endpoints of a segment, it means it's lying on the perpendicular bisector. Okay, so these are the two parts to this theorem. We come to the first construction. Turn to page number 52 of your textbook. Construction 1. Now, look into your textbooks, page number 52. The first construction, to construct a triangle when its base, an angle adjacent to the base and the sum of the lengths of the remaining sides is given. So we are going to learn how to do this construction. Question, construct triangle ABC in which BC equal to 6.3 cm, angle B 75 degrees, AB plus AC equal to 9 cm. Now, we are first drawing a rough figure. So BC is 6.3, angle B is 75 degrees and we have taken ABC. Okay. Now, what you are going to do is, for this particular figure, we will be taking BD, which is equal to 9 cm. Okay. Because we don't know where this point A lies. So we will take BC 6.3, we will construct angle B 75 degrees, and on this line we are going to take BD, which is equal to 9 cm, the sum of AB plus AC. Okay. Now this is 9 cm. Now what is the logic behind this particular construction? Once we draw BD as 9 cm, see, now here it's written BD equal to AB plus AC, which is equal to 9 cm. Now we have to locate point A on the ray BD. Now BA plus AD is equal to BA plus AC, which is equal to 9. Therefore, AD equal to AC means what they are telling, BA plus AD, this whole thing is 9 cm. This is also equal to BA plus AC, which is equal to 9 according to the question. That means what? AD is equal to AC. Now, if AD equal to AC, where should the point lie? It should lie on the perpendicular bisector of the segment CD. We just learned perpendicular bisector theorem says every point which lies on the perpendicular bisector is equidistant to the two endpoints. So we have to join CD, draw the perpendicular bisector, point A will lie on the perpendicular bisector and hence AD will be equal to AC. Okay, so this is your explanation. Now for all these questions, you have to draw a rough figure, you have to write the explanation like this, and then we draw the correct original figure. You don't have to write steps of construction for any of these questions. Only rough figure, explanation, and to draw the original figure. I'm going to draw the original figure and show you how to do it. Okay. So here, first thing that we do is you are going to draw BC, which is 6.3 cm. So let's draw this. This is BC and this is 6.3 cm. Now at angle B, we have to draw 75 degrees. So keep your protractor at the point B. Measure 75 degrees. See, from 0, 0 lies on this line. So measure the inside part. This is 70. This point is 75. Now using a scale, join B to this particular point and you get 75 degrees. Okay. Now, what did we say? BA plus AD is 9 centimeter. So using your scale and compass, measure 9 centimeter This is 9 centimeter. So now keep your steel point at B here and cut an arc. Okay. Now this point that you have got is point D and this whole distance is 9 centimeter. Okay. Now what you will do is this whole distance is 9 centimeter. Now what did we say? We will join C to D and draw the perpendicular bisector of CD. Correct? Now how to draw the perpendicular bisector? Steel point at C, more than half the distance of CD, we cut an arc on both sides of the line. Now steel point at D, do not change the measure, same method, cut an arc on both sides. The point where both these arcs meet, draw a line to join the arcs. Now, this perpendicular bisector meets the first line at this particular point. This point is going to be your A. Join A to C. This is your required triangle ABC. BC 6.3, angle B 75 degrees. AB plus AC is 9 centimeter. How do I understand it is 9? BA plus AD is equal to 9 centimeter. Now, since we have drawn the perpendicular bisector, we know that AD is congruent to AC. So, BA plus, in place of AD, I can replace it with AC because both are congruent. So, BA plus AC is equal to 9 centimeter. So, this was your required construction. AB, angle B 75, BC 6.3 and AB plus AC is 9 centimeter. And thus, triangle ABC is the required triangle. Children, I hope you have understood this construction. You need to draw the rough figure. You have to write the explanation as given in the textbook that I explained and draw this construction, draw this figure. You don't have to write steps of construction. Okay. Now, the one that I have done is a solved example in your textbook. Now, you are going to do exercise 4.1, question numbers 1, 2 and 3. Okay. Question numbers 1, 2 and 3. Question number 4 is not there. It is deleted. So, first 3 questions. So, this will be your homework. And problem set also. You can start problem set 4. You can do first question. Problem set 4. Problem set 4. You can do the first question, which is exactly the same as this particular construction. Okay. So, that's all for today, children. Thank you.